Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm starting off by using Too Faced Hangover Face Primer just to prime and moisturize my face. Then for the next primer, I'm going in with Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. Then for the next primer to conceal my under eye circles, dark circles, pimple areas, I'm going in with LA Girl Pro Concealer and Orange Corrector. And I'm going in with a beauty blender just to blend everything out. Okay, and I'm using the Josie Marion Oregon Oil and Estee Lauder Double Wear in the shade Nutmeg. And I like to go in with the Oregon Oil to help balance the Double Wear foundation because the Double Wear foundation is super matte to my skin. Consider my skin is a combination to dry. So I'd like to put some type of moisture back into my foundation. And the two works perfectly together. And I'm just going in with a brush by Tarte just to blend everything out. I think it's a Kabuki brush, I believe. And for the concealer, I'm using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC45. And just want to make sure I blend all the concealer out. You have to work fast with this concealer because I've noticed it dries super fast. And I'm going in with Ben Nye Banana Powder just to set my concealer area. And for the setting powder, I normally switch between the Ben Nye Banana Powder and the Laura Mercier, the more of the yellow tone. Both are great setting powders. And to prime my eyelid, I'm going in with MAC Paintily Paint Pot just to give my eyeshadow a base to stick to. And I'm going in with the Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette. I don't know the names of the eyeshadow shades because I threw the insert away. So this color is more of a yellow mustard color. And for the crease, I'm going in with this orange eyeshadow. I definitely just want to take my time and pack that orange shadow, eyeshadow color in my crease area and just build the intensity up. Okay, next I'm going in with a more of a dark orange reddish tone eyeshadow. And I did get a little fallout with these eyeshadow colors. And I'm just going in with a clean blending brush just to blend any harsh lines, making sure everything is blended out evenly. And to deepen up the crease, I'm going in with the more of an eggplant purple eyeshadow. And I'm just focusing that color on the outer corner of my eye. And to do a cut crease, I'm going back in with the MAC Paintily Paint Pot. And I just want to take the cut crease halfway in. And I'm going in with two eyeshadow colors. One of them is a metallic maroon color, and I can't think of the other color to describe it, but I'm mixing the two together. And I did spray my brush just to get a more of a metallic fall look. And I went in with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. And I'm just going back in, cleaning up any harsh lines, making sure everything is evenly blended out evenly. This look is more of a grungy type of eyeshadow look that I'm going for. And I'm just cleaning up any fallout eyeshadow. And to line my waterline, I'm going in with Tarte Tardius Double Eyeliner Pencil. And I'm going in with a more small tapered MAC eyeshadow brush, and I'm just repeating the same steps. Going in with the orange and the burnt orange eyeshadow on my lower lash line. And for the liquid liner, I'm using Hard Candy liquid in black. Okay, for some reason I lost some footage. So for contour, I use Fenty Beauty Espresso. And for blush, I use MAC Peaches. And for the highlight, I use Artist Contour in Conceited. And for the lip pencil, I'm using MAC Chestnut. And for lipstick, I'm using Kat Von D Mini Lipstick in Lugwig, which is a new brown liquid matte lipstick. To set everything into place, I'm using Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. And if you like what you've seen so far, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give me 2 big thumbs up. Until next time, bye.